Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can explore Report Builder both in Salesforce Classic and Lightning Experience. Before starting, if you go to description of this video, you will find links of various playlists related to Salesforce. So you can follow them as well. So now, first I'm going to tell you how we can create a simple report, that is tabular report, in Salesforce Lightning Experience. So in Lightning, if you click on Reports tab, so this new report option will be available. So once you click on this button, so you need to choose the report type. So these are some standard report types, and if you want to create custom report type, so that you can choose on which object you want to create report. So in my previous video, I demonstrated that, like how you can create custom report types. So you can watch that. So that is also available in the reports and dashboard playlist. Now, here in this video, I'm selecting this accounts report type, that is standard one. Clicking on continue. So this report will be based on accounts. So this way you can see these are the default fields that are selected. So here, if you want to put more fields, so from here you can search the fields. So let's say you want to add account revenue. So I clicked on that. So here you can see this account revenue field is available. And if you click on run, so that will be displayed along with these default fields. And if you click on add it back, so it is available here. If you want to remove any particular field, so you can click on this cross sign, so that will be removed. So let's say if I remove this one, so that will be removed. And if you click on run, so that change will be reflected. So that particular column is removed from here. Again, you can click on edit. So here filters are also available, so you can manage those as well. So if I click on this show me, so these are two default filters. So if I click on show me, so it is showing my accounts only. If you want to see all accounts, so you need to click on here and click on apply. So it will show all the accounts. So you need to click on run so that you can see a whole list. So total four records are available. And if I modify the second filter, then that will be increased. So right now start date is 19/5 and end date is no. So I'm going to change this. So from here, I'm selecting all time. And if you want to select current fiscal year, previous to fiscal year, to financial year ago, next fiscal year. So this way, you can change a financial year, fiscal year, calendar year. Many options are available here, but I am selecting all time and clicking on apply. So now you will see number of records will be increased. So again, I'm clicking on run. Yeah, here you can see total 26 field records are available, right? So that default filter was filtering as per the criteria. So less number of records were displayed. So I hope this thing you understood how we can manage the standard filters. Now, if you want to apply custom filter, so you can click on add filter. You can select a particular field. So let's say I am selecting rating. So here you can see some records are not having any rating. They are blank. So I am going to remove those. So rating equals to warm, cold, and hot. So if it is equals to this, or you can say not equals to, and you can select blank. So anyway, you can create this and click on apply. So this is the custom filter that we applied. And if I click on run, so this time you will see all the records which are having a rating populated are displayed only. So only 13 records are displayed here. So this way you can apply your custom filter as well, right? And if you click on here, so you can add logic, filter logic. So if you have multiple filters, so you can apply like one and two or one or two. So this way you can put and or between your filters. So right now we have only one filter. That's why we can't put that. If you have more than one filter, so you can put one and two or three kind of thing. And next is add cross filters. So if you want to apply cross filters like account with or without, and you want to choose any other object as well. So let's say context. So account with context, if you want to apply this cross object filter. So from here, you can select any other object as well. So these are those records which are having context associated with them. So total 8 records are there. So this way, if you want to apply cross object filter, that can be applied from here as well. And if you want to select account without context and apply, so those accounts will be displayed. They are not associated with any context. So this is 0. Right, so this way you can apply the filters as per your requirement. Okay, so both are applied. That's why it is not showing anything. So I'm removing this one. Now I am running this. Yeah, so only 5 records are displayed here. So this way, as per your requirement, whatever records you want to filter out, you can apply the filter. So you can create custom filters. 2 standard filters are there. And you can apply the filter logic as well, and you can add cross filters also. So these things are available with this report builder. So I hope you understood these things with Salesforce Lightning. And this I am explaining for tabular reports only. In my another video, you will get to know how we can create tabular reports, matrix reports, summary reports. And if you want to save this, you can click on save. If you want to first save and then run, so you can click on this button. So let's say I'm saving this report. So new account report for Lightning Experience. And I'm clicking on save, so it will be saved. Right, so this was all about Lightning Experience. Now we are going to move to Salesforce Classic. So I'm going to click on this link, switch to Salesforce Classic. So UI of Salesforce Classic is a bit different from Lightning Experience. So here we need to search for the report tab. So click on this plus sign, search for the report. So here it is, click on this. So that report tab is open. So here you can see at left hand side, all the folders are available. These are the reports. So some are created in Lightning Experience, and now we can create report here as well. So you need to click on this new report, and as we selected report type in Lightning, we need to select them here as well. So I'm clicking on this plus. Let's say I'm selecting accounts and clicking on create. So unsaved report is created and report type is accounts. And here you can see these are the default fields. If I want to add any particular field, so let's say I am adding industry. So I need to drag and drop it here. So you can compare the UI of Lightning and Classic. In Lightning, we can just search for the field and it will be added automatically. But here we need to drag and drop the field so that it can be added. And if I drag and drop it to here, so it will be removed. So here you can see it is updating. So it is a tabular format of the report. So in Classic, you can see all the report types are available here, report formats, tabular, summary, matrix, and join. So we can create 4 types of reports. And in Lightning, these are not directly available. So in my another video, you can see how we can create those kind of reports. So if you want to run reports, so it will be displayed. So this way it shows the output. And if you click on customize, so again, you will go to that report builder. And here we can add the filters. So this is first default filter, my account. So if you want to choose all accounts, you can click here. And if you want to choose the date field range, so as we selected all time, and these are the fiscal years. So you can choose anyone as per your requirement. I'm choosing all time. So all account record will be displayed. So this way you can filter out all the records. So if you click on run reports, so these many records are displayed. Now click on customize. So here you can see we can click on add and we can apply the filters. Cross filters also we can apply. We can apply the row limits as well here. So if I click on add filters, so we apply rating not equals to and blank. So I'm clicking on OK. So only those records will be displayed which are having rating populated. So here you can see. And if you want to apply cross filter, so you can choose this one. So as we applied this in Lightning, so similarly you can apply this here as well. So I'm not showing this because I already demonstrated this in Lightning. And if you want to apply filter logic, so if you have multiple filters, then you can apply the logic like this, and or you can put. And if you want to apply row limits, so you can do that as well. So row limit is 10. If you want to increase that, you want to apply sorting, so you can do that as well. So this way, I hope you understood this thing in Salesforce Classic. If you want to save this report, you can click here. So it will be asking the report name, its unique name, the folder where you want to save it. So this way you can save this report in Salesforce Classic. So I hope with this video you understood report builder both in Salesforce Lightning experience and Salesforce Classic. Because in some of the projects you might need both the things. So you should be familiar with both Classic and Lightning report builders because they have some differences in them while implementing the reports. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. And if you want to watch more reports and dashboard related videos, so you can find the playlist link in the description of this video and at the end of this video. So do follow that so that you can understand each and everything related to reports and dashboard in Salesforce. Thank you for watching this video.